Liz, how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it, it was fucking great. What's new with the old man?
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever then.
Brother, you have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis. She's looking good. Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your cop.
All right, come on. I'm ready to go home.
Since we got your telegram about coming home, we've been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed? What if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you to come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
I won't.
He'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama Hell, you know how he gets. Empire Bay a year or so after you shipped out. Started selling weed. They call and ask me if I want something. I say, sure. It's free money as far as I'm concerned. Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line and says they're moving into heroin, that they're looking for a partner down around these parts.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I never told about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about.
I ain't said more than 3 words and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood.
We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got any money to begin with. Fucking around aside, that was pretty serious shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man, I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
No way Sal's gonna go along with that.
Georgie says he can keep his old man from fighting out. We'll steer clear of the hollow with Frisco, just selling the French wall. Georgie's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man. Georgie's a cool cat and all, but heroin ain't the kiddie pool.
Come in on it with us. I bet he can agree to a 3-way split.
I don't know. I kind of need to lay low a bit, figure some things out.
Yeah. All right.
Not the big nigga who ate him.
Well, shit, old man. I finally went somewhere they knew how to cook.
Welcome home, son. How are you?
I'll be better once I get some of that shine in me.
I always did love corn whiskey. I would like to make a toast. My father used to say that the real worth of a man came from the mark he left on the world. When Lincoln first told me he was joining the military, I was against it. Too dangerous, I say. Let those people fight their own war, I say. But then I realized Lincoln needed to go out and make his mark. And that's precisely what he did. I'm so, so proud of you. For Lincoln! Bienvenue à la maison!
For Lincoln! Bienvenue à la maison!
So good. Nice seeing you, Lincoln. Oh, I kept you in my prayers.
I really appreciate that, Father.
Now who wants to get shit-faced?
Me!
It's hard to explain what it's like coming home from war. Elation? Fear? Imagine being trapped in a dark room and there's no way out. And every fear, every nightmare you ever had is in that room with you. And there's no escape from any of it. And then, one day, a door opens, and you're free to go. Just like that. The thing is, you made your peace with your terror and your fear of death. And now part of you is afraid to leave it behind. But what choice do you have? Every soldier has to walk through that door. One way or another.
Man, Whiskey's gonna hoit in the morning.
Hell, man, just sleep it off. The room's the same as he left it.
I'm gonna take the basement.
The basement? Why the fuck you wanna crash down there?
I'll see you in the morning.
Man, that wall must have really fucked you up. We barely have two nickels struck together. Now we're paying for all that food. Jesus Christ!
Watch that mouth of yours.
We wouldn't be in this mess if you would have listened to me.
What mess?
Not something you need to worry about, Lincoln. I got it under control.
Under control? God damn it, you need
to... Boy, I'm not warning you again!
Have it your way, old man!
Let him be. He needs to cool off.
You mind telling me what's got him so riled up?
We've been having problems with the Haitians. But like I say, I got it under control.
Well, truck's all loaded up. I figure we got enough out there for... Should I come back?
In honor of your returning to us safe and sound, I made a donation to Father James here. Supplied him with food he can hand out to some of our needier family.
I was hoping you'd lend me a hand, Lincoln, to give you a chance to see the neighborhood.
This thing with the Haitians, how serious is it?
Ah, you know it is. Someone looks at him the wrong way, he's on them like a wet dog.
Like I said, I can come back.
Nonsense. Lincoln needs to get out, enjoy the day,
Besides, be good for the two of you to spend some time together. Go on. Those people waiting on their food.
Oh, I saw Lang a couple times once he was first back. He told me he wanted to leave town, head out to California. Now, he had a friend in the service who could get him a job working at the Mare Island shipyard. And the only reason he came back was to tell Sammy and Ellis goodbye. But then he found out about the trouble Sammy was having with those Haitians. So he decided to stay and help. Those Haitians, they are bad news. No talking Lankin out of it. Whatever else he might have become, Lankin was always loyal.
Was. Past tense.
Likely. 3-month apprenticeship to start, then the union lets you in.
You tell Sammy and Ellis?
Not yet. Gonna wait a few days. Didn't want to spring it on them since I just got back.
Well, they won't like to hear it, but they'll come around. You need to do what's best for you. Go ahead and start serving those folks. I'll be back. Give Sammy my best, Lincoln.
Yes, sir.
Warm meal, warm heart. Oh, sure. Thanks.
Nice to see you. You delivering a real blessing here, Lincoln. Thank you.
Blessing's mine, ma'am.
Couple of days back and they already got you working?
I'm happy to do it.
Means a hell of a lot to all of us.
Don't get old, son. It's a fucking shit show.
I'll see what I can do about that.
Hey there, Lincoln.
How are you, Regine?
I'm good. Nice to see you around the hollow again.
Nice to see those big brown eyes again.
Well, they'll be over at my aunt's place with the rest of me. You should stop by.
Maybe I'll do that.
Megan, we got trouble!
Run, Regine!
Once we're done with you, Lincoln, stop his neck!
Duvalier was elected president of Haiti in 1957. By 1959, he had created a secret police called Tonton Macoot, and people started to flee. Most of them settled in the southern United States. Now, mixed in with the good, hard-working people were hardened criminals. You know, they formed the backbone of what became the Haitian gang. Now, Lincoln found out they set up in the swamps and were led by a man named Baca.
Yeah. You and Father James done already?
We got jumped by the Haitians. It's time you level with me. Tell me what's really going on.
Yes. I suppose it is.
6 or 7 months ago, folks in the Hollow started getting robbed. Money, jewelry, things of that nature. Didn't take long for us to figure out it was the Haitians. And those badass on the law started going after the lottery.
How much money are we talking about? How much?
Enough that we're in deep shit with Sal Marcano. Haven't kicked up to him in 3 months.
Jesus Christ. If I deal with them, that gives us time to settle up with Marcano, right?
Let me worry about Sal. He and I go way back. This thing with the Haitians, it's time for it to end. You and Ellis need to handle it.
How we gonna find him?
Back in the 20s, folks used to pull salt out of the bayou. They built themselves a little shanty town. When the Depression hit, they abandoned it. That's the only place this could have come from.
Gonna need guns and ammo.
Call this number. But do it away from here. No sense tipping anybody off.
Or we could sweep the Hollow, track down and kill every last one of those cocksuckers, then we wouldn't have to worry about it.
The last thing folks in this neighborhood need to see is colored people killing each other. Do this quiet. Away from here.
Once we eliminate whoever's running the show, the rest of them will go down on their own. Trust me.
All right, soldier boy. I'll follow your lead.
Be careful here. Those Haitians are hard people. Do not ever underestimate them. C'est bien que c'est divers et c'est.
You sure this is how you want to play this?
Last thing they're gonna expect is an attack from the water. You head back round to the road. Stay with the car. I'll meet you over there when this is done.
Hope you know what you're doing.
Trust me, Ellis. Here in a bit, this will all be behind us.
Boss says if we have to burn down half the Hollow to get to Sammy, we're doing it. Ain't stopping till that old man's dead.
Him, Alice, Papa laid by open the gate for me.
This time he won't get away from us.
weird place. Get out. This guy. What do you do? Where is this fool?
The body here! Fine. I will shit. He was just here.
Looking to refine him. until we find it.
Over here.
Your people, Katsuka!
One bullet left. Behind there, yeah.
Get down with you, you idiot. God almighty.
Take it easy. He kept me in there, locked in there,
never going to be over. Pajam!
Fucking Haitians.
He's coming this way. Joe H., Sammy's boys in there. Get it!
What the fuck? Down, you... lucky idiot. Oh my god.
Reloading, cover me!
Bastards. Oh my god, what are you doing?
Get him!
God, you're the controls
us. You're
are
against
fucking
us.
Ridiculous.
Shoot at that fool!
Shoot him from the side!
Fuck you.
Didn't understand, or maybe want to understand, is that for a man like Sammy, there's always gonna be more Haitians. Now, if there wasn't someone going after Sammy, then there was someone else forcing him into a bad situation. It was never gonna end. That's how Lincoln ended up working for Sal Marcano.
You were right about those Haitians being down by that old salt mine. It won't be bothering us again.
It was a mistake sending you down there. I should handle my own business.
This isn't any different than what I was doing before I left.
You probably don't know this, but every night on the TV, right after the news, they show the names of all the boys killed over there in Vietnam. I'd be sitting in the kitchen eating my supper, watching that list scroll by, wondering if today is the day I finally see your name.
But you never did. Nothing happened to me.
There's only so much luck down the well. Sooner or later, pull up that bucket, there's nothing in it.
So, what are we gonna do about Marcano?
Pay him his goddamn money one way or the other.
Lottery gonna be enough to cover it?
The lottery? No. But Sal called a bit ago. Wants you to meet him at the country club. Says he's got something in the works. Square things up between us.
The only black folk allowed in there to help.
Now, they may not like it, but they're not gonna say no to Sal Marcano. He says you get to come in, you get to come in.
Fine. Always did want to see the inside of that place.
You need to do whatever Sal asks, yeah? For all our sakes.
Yes, sir.
What are you doing?
Rotten!
Oh my god.
For the upcoming Mardi Gras festivals, retail ready center is buy two, get one free. Can't beat that? Go on over there, tell her I sent you. I know, I'm not supposed to enjoy my coffee on air. Oh, Gilbert's turning red, folks. Oh, I tell you, we like to have our fun here, listen. And that's what Mardi Gras is going to be all about. Good old-fashioned New Bordeaux F-U-N. And if I sound a little enthusiastic, well, I'm sorry about it. But I am. I've talked before about being honored to be part of the crew of knights for the 10th year run. We got a heck of a float plan for y'all, and we have spared no expense in strutting our stuff. Now, this will be my first crew since my dad died last year. So you know how important Mardi Gras was to him. God rest his soul, he was one of the crew of knights founders. He was captain for 4 years, and I can't remember, and Daddy was Rex back in 1932, for those of you whose memories go all the way back there. Oh, you know, I'll tell you, he'd spend weeks, that months, preparing. More than anything else, it was the tradition. Feeling being part of something. The city that he loved so. My father believed that every man had a role to play, a role to contribute to the greater whole. The Reds over in Russia, even the ones here at home, they tried to sell that as he wanted. No, sir. There's always going to be a king. And each king has his name. Sure is fine. On the next episode, you better believe we're going to talk about this here story that President Johnson is considering a deal with the Russians to scale back our nuclear program. That and a lot more right here. Native Son.
fuck you doing up here? Help goes into the back.
I'm here to see Mr. Marcano. The name's Lincoln Clay.
That a fact? I'll be goddamned. Mind your manners while you're in there, boy. Or there'll be hell to pay you here.
Shit themselves when they saw you coming.
Been a long time, Georgie.
Oh, no shit, it's been a long time. I think the last time I saw you was that night over in the French Ward, right before you shipped out. Damn, that wasn't a gas.
Oh, I seem to remember me and Ellis running from the cops. And Danny ended up in the drunk tank.
Hell, man, I bet it out. Besides, just worth it to knock the hell out of them crack of assholes. Smoke?
Sure.
Oh, man.
Sammy said Mr. Marcano wanted to see me.
Mr. Marcano? Shit, make him sound like a goddamn lawyer. Just call him Sam. Oh, he's in the back.
I should have wore something else.
In these squares, I promise your dress. I'm taking up with my old man. He'll tell him to kiss his ass. Thing
about having
fuck you, man.
Olivia, I hate to cut this short, darling, but I've got a meeting coming up. Remy, a pleasure as always, sir. Two more glasses.
Lincoln, good to see you. This is Vito Scaletta. He's the one I've been telling you about. Come on, Lincoln, sit down.
So you served in Vietnam, huh?
Yes, sir.
Sal tells me you earned a few pieces of tin over there.
Well, I served with some good men. Nothing I did would have happened without them.
Army? Marines?
Regular Army at first, and then I was recruited to the 5th SFG.
Special Forces.
I told you it was something else. Now, not that anything's gonna go wrong, but just in case, goddamn, don't you want a man like that on your side?
Well, if you're vouching for him, Sal, that's good enough for me. Look, I got a couple things to take care of. Thanks for the drink.
Christ, that guy's an asshole. Fucking carpetbagger. Commission sent him down here from Empire Bay about 15 years back. He's been a pain in my goddamn ass ever since. Well, I guess you're wondering what this is all about.
Yeah, Sammy didn't tell me too much.
Twice a year, the feds take old money out of circulation and destroy it. Over the course of the next few days, that money's gonna be delivered here to the reserve in town.
And you're gonna hit one of those shipments?
No, sir. We are gonna use that occasion to gain access to their vault.
And then steal everything that ain't nailed down. Should be $6-7 million in there, easy.
That's pretty fucking ballsy.
It's a chance of a goddamn lifetime is what it is.
Now, Vito's fronting a lot of the money for the job, and he got us the combination to the vault. Have you had a chance to see Danny?
No, not yet.
Oh, well, you will. We brought him and his old man in on this, and they're gonna need your help, so go see them. They're still in that same place.
There's something else we gotta talk about. Now, it's safe to assume you know about the problem Sammy's been having.
I took care of the Haitians. Once things settle down, money will start coming in again.
You see that right there? That's what I'm talking about. You didn't sit around with your thumb jammed in your ass. You saw a problem, you went out and took care of it. God damn, I take that over money any day of the week.
We pay our own way, debts and all. Always have.
Hell, son, I know that. I wouldn't expect otherwise. But you know, even after we all evened up, you're still gonna be slopping around in the ass end of this city. Not much of a future in that. But maybe there's a different way forward, you understand? For all of us.
What you have in mind?
I want you to know I mean no disrespect when I say this. Sammy's a hell of a man, but he's not getting any younger. And I'm thinking it's time to make a change.
Well, I don't think that Ellis is ready for that
conversation. I'm not talking about Ellis. I'm talking about you. I want you to run the holler.
can't do that.
Well, look here, if you're worried about Sammy, don't you understand? Now, he's always been on the level with me. And this job we're talking about, there's more than enough for him to retire on.
He took me in when I had nowhere else to go. Treated me like a son. I'm sorry, Mr. Marcano. I can't do that to him.
Well, shit, son. I'd be lying if I didn't say I wasn't just a little disappointed. But I get it. You're loyal, which is something that is scarce these days.
Do you still want me to help with this thing we've been talking about?
You goddamn right I do! And when it's all done, you all be more than square with me. You have my word.
What do you really want to hear? That we kidnap and torture anyone suspected of working with the BC?
I'm trying to ascertain the level of training that Lincoln Clay received during his time in Vietnam.
Someone like that you don't need to train. You point them in the right direction and get the fuck out of their way.
What took you guys so long?
Piece of shit drill cap overheating. You and Lincoln Boss still in one piece?
Yeah, we good. Where's Danny?
He's pushing everything off to the side so that we have room to catch the money.
Alright, well, once you squared away up here, we start dropping it down.
But make it quick.
Motherfuckers killed the lights.
Just worry about the money. I'll deal with this. Those guards will cut us down the second we make a break for it. Tell Danny he needs to get us out of here.
And these bastards got us pinned down. Y'all need to figure something out.
I got some TNT. I'll put out outside the hole and detonate it.
What the fuck is that gonna accomplish?
If any luck, it'll blow a hole big enough for y'all to drop down.
But any luck, Danny, do you even know what the fuck you're doing?
All this dynamite, how complicated could it be? It's lit. Get the fuck away from the hole.
Why Sal Marcano turned on Thomas Burke, but he took Point Verdun from him and gave it to an enforcer named Roman the Butcher Barbieri, who promptly busted up one of Burke's legs. Now, Danny Burke was part of the heist crew. I mean, he was a gearhead, had never done anything like this before, but Thomas Burke insisted. He figured if the heist was a success, Sal would forgive him and return Point Verdun.
Hey, now I heard there ain't nothing sweeter than Vietnamese pussy. You tell me it's true. Casanova Clay. Shit, man, it's so fucking good to see you.
You too, Danny. How's Nikki?
Damn, she wanted to be here, but I ain't remember how long.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Come on, let's grab a beer. Wait for the old man to chill out, and then we can get down to it.
Yeah. It's okay.
Yeah, I already got it all set up and organized. All the girls gonna be there and everything, except we just gotta go in my cars because we can't roll up in that beat-up piece of shit outside.
Well, you didn't just call my all-American machine a beater.
I'm just saying there are better rides out there.
It's bullshit there are. This car's a beast. I dropped the custom 358 in before he shipped out.
That ain't the only thing you dropped in there. Maybe you should tell me about how you'd borrow it from Ellis and take the ladies for a ride.
Hell, man, leave me out of this.
Did you fuck in my car?
Nah, ain't no big deal. I was always wrapped up tight. Besides, I already got one fucking bass in my life. I don't need another one.
All right, you know what? You go clean. Not just the back seat, every square inch. I don't need to be riding around sitting in your shit.
Hey, and you, funny man, you want fucking help?
Like hell I am, shit, I didn't get any.
Yeah, well, this is new.
Jesus Christ, you fucking Joker's got about as much chance of pulling this off as I do at winning a goddamn decathlon.
Oh, all right, Dad, we need.
Donnie and Ellis, you're gonna use the drills to cut a hole up through the bottom of the vault. You and Georgie, you'll be inside. You're gonna drop the money down, then get the hell out of there. That goddamn drill ain't easy to move, though. So we need a boat to get it through the canals and into position.
Ellis and I are worried about the boat. See, George's old man flipped the guard to reserve, giving you his truck.
Between that and the uniforms, ain't no one gonna give us a second look.
Come on, let's get moving. Still gotta swing by Skeletta to finish up some prep work.
Hey, and you two assholes, don't think this gets you off the hook when it comes to my car. Y'all best get ready to clean it.
I ain't cleaning shit.
Hey, you cleaning it.
My father was a lot of things, few of them good. But he started out smuggling moonshine, so he knew about the canals underneath the city, and that one of them went right under the Federal Reserve. It was his idea to use a boat to move the drill into position. He was a real son of a bitch, my father. More than anyone else, I blame him for what happened. To stick your own neck out, fine, but leave your son out of it. It's his fault Danny died.
Gonna tell that Mary Bond of the dawn. He claimed he has a music, but he has
a warning. We need to go.
We're all here. Go, hold it. Let me get the fuck out of here! Yeah.
We'll find another way out of here. This tunnel has to go somewhere.
None of this makes any sense. That can't be how it happened.
Oh my god. Whoo, that was bad. That was bad. Oh god.
We'll find another way out of here. This tunnel has to go somewhere.
Everybody all right?
That was the craziest fucking thing I've ever saw.
I'm glad we're breathing and all, but what the hell are we gonna do now?
Only option is to head up.
Are you kidding me? There'll be cops all over the place.
Well, and any luck, they'll be too busy dealing with Mardi Gras. Notice us. Let's go.
Damn it, this ain't a gas. Hey, you sure you need to grab that much of my ass?
Oh, shut up and keep climbing, man. Yeah, I hit a payphone. Call to the ride.
Can you walk?
Yeah, somebody give me a hand. I can get one.
It's probably just gonna be easier to carry a sorry ass. Hold up. Come here.
Hey! Don't put me the fuck down!
If anybody asks, we say he's drunk. Y'all pick up that money. Let's go.
Oh, god damn it.
Thank you.
watch it.
Hey, man, get off the phone. Right fucking now.
Oh, I insist that you apologize.
Y'all keep an eye out.
Multitasking.
We're in some deep shit. Need your help.
Where are you?
Just off the parade route. Danny's hurt.
I can't get a car to you because the roads are closed off. Listen, there's a grocery store on the backside of the cemetery. Can you get over there?
Yeah.
There'll be a car waiting at the loading dock. And Lincoln, be careful, yeah? You and Ellie's boat.
We will. Sammy's having a car delivered. It'll be at the loading dock at the grocery store.
God bless the old man. Let's go.
Watch where you're going.
Officer, the gate.
arrested.
We need to move.
This is bullshit. Again! This guy is fucking useless! Oh my fucking days. He's gonna make three shots and he's fucked. Man, this is getting repetitive. Die, repeat, die, repeat, die, repeat. In that order.
35, suspicious personnel code. Responding unit investigating. Fucking move! He's got me stuck!
Hear another car! Need to get behind something!
Great, no fucking bullets. Brilliant. Good observation. Marvelous.
Wait a second.
Yeah, I get it. God, what's he doing this way?
Negative visual on suspect. Repeat, visual contact lost.
Bastard!
Doesn't show that what you're saying is the truth, does it? We've come.
Well, how much is it? A little over $2 million. Per split. Holy mother God.
Once everything's settled up, I'm calling the man I know, having him bring over 300.
Boy, ain't no hooker ever stepping foot in this house.
You sure? Because two of them are for you.
I'm gonna be fucking in my new grift.
I'd appreciate that.
You know, my entire life, there's always been someone standing over me, telling me, where I could go, what I could do, who I could be seen with. This. What you boys did tonight. This changes everything. This isn't just money. It's freedom. Real freedom. Ain't no one standing over me again. Over any of us, huh? Vouloir c'est pouvoir, huh? Vouloir c'est pouvoir!
Well, well, well.
Man, it's
oh, and look at what I dug up. You mind pouring one more though?
Holy shit. It'd be my pleasure.
Judge, he told me shit went sideways during the robbery. Lincoln had to save your ass. You should be damn proud of that, boy.
I am, Sam. More than you'll ever know.
Oh, Jesus Christ, that is some down-home hooch right there, isn't it? Right. Listen, I got a guy outside. You don't mind if he comes in and packs up my cut?
Not at all.
Look at that.
See
if you can handle this down-home hooch. I'll give you some of that.
Can I get some corn whiskey? Thank you, man.
They all the same. Hey, take the one on the end. It's your cut. Plus what I owe you. Even put in a little extra for your trouble.
Couldn't have pulled it off without you, Sammy. Y'all done right by me tonight. Mwah. Mwah. Why don't you get us something off the top shelf? We need to celebrate.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You ain't got to tell me, boy.
Hey, fill me up.
There was something Lincoln, possibly the baddest motherfucker I ever laid my eyes on.
You shouldn't have said no.
Revenge is gonna be sweet.
The whole place was burning. I still don't know what brought me there that night. Look, divine providence. Or something else. Tell me to call John Donovan. So that's what I did. Most days I wish I never made that call.
Mr. Donovan, do you know this individual?
Sure. Sal Marcano.
Mm-hmm. And how about this man?
That's Sal's worthless piece of shit brother, Lou. Look, enough of the dog and pony bullshit. What's your real question?
Did you help Lincoln Clay murder Sal Marcano and all prominent members of his crime family?
You're goddamn right I did.
I see the moon rising. I see trouble on the way. I see earthquakes of lightning. I see bad times today. Don't go around tonight.
So it was the man you're gonna kill, huh?
That's the plan, Padre.
It's a dangerous course you're contemplating.
And what do you think we should do?
Sal Marcano deserves to die. I won't argue otherwise. Kill him. But let that be the end of it.
That's not enough!
It's enough if you say it's enough. I know what Sal did to you, Lincoln. But nothing you do will bring any of them back.
This isn't about bringing them back. Or even exacting some street justice. It's about making that bastard feel what it's like to lose everything. Watch as I take it all away from him.
It's the one-way road, Lincoln. And once you start down it, there ain't no turning back.
I'm going to Sammy's to get my stuff. You ready?
I'll be waiting in the car.
Taught us kids to turn the other cheek, not fight back. Problem is, that don't work. Not in the real world.
off the drugs. What's going on here? Oh, Jesus Christ. What was that all about? Again.
Red beans and rice like my mama does. Heard they're flying James L. Ray back this week.
Still amazes me they expect us to believe it was one man who did end up the game.
It's too easy. Too bad.
Let's say he was the one who shot Dr. King. Just him and no one else. What if it's really that easy to strike down a great man like Dr. King, President Kennedy, Brother Malcolm?
Then nothing in this country will ever change.
Now you struggle and you sweat and someone can take it all away just like that.
Looking good, chocolate pudding.
Out of the hollow. Give me your boss and I'll make it happen. Fuck. Shit. Get to the voodoo shop. You'll find the boss there.
Sorry about the headache, brother.
Fuck him up!
Understand what he's doing.
trick you pulled back at the Haitian camp, pretending Baca was holding you prisoner.
And I yelled, you are dead. It appears we both full of surprises.
Certainly does.
What can I do for you, Lincoln Clay?
I want you to help me kill Sal Marcano.
I see. A few months ago, you was trying to kill me. Now you break in here and expect me to trust you?
Now that Marcano's back in the Dixie Mafia, it's only a matter of time till they come for you. And when they do, they'll kill everyone standing in their way.
Lest I hitch my horse to your wagon, so to speak.
I'll see to it that you get the hollow. After that, depends on how things shake out.
Do you know why Sammy and I were at war?
On account of you going after the lottery.
Please. Just because you don't want to face some uncomfortable truths ain't a reason to act naive. Sammy and I were fighting because the people in the holler deserve better than a two-faced old man who handed out cans of food whenever the mood hit him. Who always did what Sal Marcano told him to do, even if it pitted him against his own people.
He did the best he could.
And yet his best didn't amount to much, did it? Once I have the holler, I run it as I see fit. No questions asked.
As long as you give me access to your muscle, your connections, and a place to hold up from time to time, you can do what you want.
Marcano replaced Sammy with a man named Richie Doucette. Do you know of him?
Assume he's Dixie Mafia.
He's a wooster! Likes to kidnap black teenagers and take them out to the bayou. After starving them for a few days, he cuts them loose, tells them to run. Sometimes he brings out the dogs, you know, for old time's sake. That's how he killed my sister. All I have left.
How do I find him?
It's still dangerous around here for him, so he stays on the move. Oh,
jeez.
It was named after Sammy's wife. I'm taking it down first.
One of my men have been staking it out. See what he can learn about how it's being run. You should talk to him. See what he knows.
Once I deal with it, I'll see about the church.
Yeah, she's a nice one.
Motherfuckers. Tell me about it. Let me know if you see something you want.
Oh yeah, never talking. buy me some firearms. $15,000. How much have I got? $1,200. Oh my god. I can't afford any of these. No, I can't afford that either. Oh, of course. I ain't buying any guns. Ooh, I can afford a Molotov cocktail, though. There we go, there's one of them. What the hell? Oh, they're locked. Ooh, cool, you can modify your vehicles. Sound. Oh, nice. Oh, well, not right now, but at a later date. What's this? Ooh, I'll have one of them. $100,000, Jesus Christ. What voice?
Show me what you got.
No, I'm late. How'd you get in there?
Lincoln, you a sight for sore eyes.
Laveau, been a while. Wasn't expecting to see you working with the Haitians.
It's either this or bow down to them fucking coon asses. And you know I ain't ever been one to bow down to anyone.
Ain't that the goddamn truth?
Cassandra phoned ahead. Say you going out to Perlis. Asshole named Merle Jackson runs it. Turned it into a brothel. That's white fellas come in and do whatever they want to our young sisters.
How do I get to him?
You don't. Not yet, anyway. Now those Dixie fucks try to stay out of sight. Then someone put a bullet up their ass.
If I hit his operations, he'll have to come out and deal with me.
I got an idea how to get his attention. He got some girls locked up on the second floor of Perlis, causing his thoroughbreds. Has them strung out on all kind of shit. He makes a lot of money off them. Go in there quiet. Get them out of there.
I'll let you know when it's done.
Hey, I'm sorry to hear about Sammy Nevis. They always did right by me.
it.
You watch it.
Excuse yourself. Mr. Lavelle told me you'd be coming. The girls are upstairs. Be careful. Merle's people are all over the place.
I will. Thanks.
Excuse me. Watch it.
God, this guy.
Light him up. Yeah, burn, boy.
Oh, why is that sly? It's fuck.
Ow, motherfucker. There you go, cocksucker.
All right, okay. That's me told.
Staring us a new one.
Fucking day.
shit here.
You killed him.
You should kill all of them. Every last one.
Get out of here. Now.
The mall. Bastard. Shotgun. I don't know what's better.
Brother, brother, calm down. You have to use a lighter touch.
What? Oh, what the hell? He made it out. This is annoying. $3,000. Oh, that's nowhere near enough.
episode of Native Son. I'm your host, Reverend Duval. How y'all doing out there? Because I'm doing just fine. Glad that winter's finally behind us, and I'm sure you are as well. So, what's going on in your world this weekend, dear listener? I have my Saturday night all planned out. I'm going to put on a nice suit, because you know old Remy has to go out up the shop. I'm going to give myself a haircut. And I'm going to have dinner with 31 very special Americans. Now, who are these people?
Something for you. You've been running around so much out there, I figured I'd make your life a little easier. You can use this to call on your support.
And here I was thinking you were a heartless asshole.
Jury's still out on that one.
Families, they come back to pieces, and the so-called hippies trying to tear them down. No, sir, not my town.
That Cassandra really buffaloed you, didn't she? Fucking lunatics. Every last one of them. I know this is personal for you, but you want to kill Sal and that dipshit son of his. You're going to need to keep your head. Jesus, everything here is either fried, covered in sugar, or both.
The hell's a fucking door? Jesus.
They don't know how to... Let's welcome our guests. Let's serve them a nice home cooked meal. Down to the yacht club.